Hi friends, today I shall explain the treatment of depreciation in final accounts. What is meant by depreciation? Depreciation is the decrease in the value of fixed assets due to wear and tear, passage of time, obsolescence, etc. It is a loss to the organization. Therefore, it must be properly accounted with a view to get the correct profit or loss of the organization and also to show the correct financial position of the business concern. As in case of outstanding expenses and prepaid expenses, this depreciation can also be given either in the adjustment or in the trial balance. I shall explain in detail with an example.
Here, a trial balance is given as on 31/3/2020. Plant and machinery is given as rupees 1 lakh in the trial balance. And an additional information, that means you need to provide depreciation of rupees 5000 on plant and machinery. On plant and machinery is given. If it is given as an adjustment, as we know, it should be taken at two places. But in the second case, plant and machinery is given as rupees 95,000 in the trial balance and depreciation is given as rupees 5,000 in the very same trial balance. Whenever the items appear in the trial balance, it will be taken only at one place. Let us consider how it will appear in the final accounts. This rupees 5,000 is a loss to the organization, therefore, it should be charged in the profit and loss account. While drafting the profit and loss account, you should debit depreciation on plant and machinery, rupees 5,000. Then again, being an adjustment item, it will appear on the asset side of the balance sheet, because whenever depreciation arises, the value of the asset will be decreased. Thus, the decreased value should be shown, that is the actual value, should be shown on the asset side of the balance sheet. That means, in the balance sheet, you can write plant and machinery rupees 1 lakh less depreciation rupees 5000, remaining 95,000 can be returned in the amount column of the balance sheet. In the second case, here the depreciation appeared in the trial balance. That means entry for the depreciation has already been passed and ended, and thereby the depreciation is already deducted from plant and machinery. That means whenever depreciation appeared in the trial balance, it conveys that the depreciation is already deducted from the concerned asset. Therefore, no need for further deduction in the balance sheet. We can directly take this plant and machinery in the balance sheet and depreciation in the profit and loss account. That is, P&L account to depreciation rupees 5000. Then in the balance sheet, plant and machinery rupees 95,000. That is all. Here I shall present the treatment of depreciation in a table. Here the item under consideration is depreciation. It may be given either in the adjustment or in trial balance. If it is given in the adjustment, that item should be debited in the profit and loss account, and also depreciation should be deducted from the concerned asset in the balance sheet. As an alternative, depreciation may be given in the trial balance. If it is given in the trial balance, the impact is that it is already recorded and that amount is already deducted from the concerned asset. Therefore, no further deduction is required in the balance sheet. So, it can be directly debited in the profit and loss account. Here, whenever you are provided with the depreciation in the adjustment,
Special attention is required. The simple reason is that very often it may not be given in absolute terms. That means the amount of depreciation may not be provided in the adjustment. Let us consider the situations one by one. Here, an asset namely loose tools is given in the track balance prepared on 31/3/2020. As per the books of accounts, its value is ₹25,000. That is why 25,000 appeared in the track balance. Now, at the time of preparation of final accounts, the business unit revalued the very same asset. What is the value at present? That is estimated. And it comes ₹24,000, which is given in the adjustment. Actually, the value of the asset decreased from ₹25,000 to ₹24,000. That means there is a decrease in the value of ₹1,000 that denotes a depreciation. How it can be entered in the final accounts? When you are preparing P&L account, there you can write to depreciation on loose tools. How you got that amount? The amount is not specified in the adjustment. Then how you got the amount? That is, the given value in the trial balance is 25,000 minus the revalued price, ₹24,000. The difference 1,000 is the depreciation that can be taken in the P&L account. Then what about balance sheet? In the balance sheet, you can write loose tools and you are having two options. Either you can directly take this revalued price there, 24,000. That is the real value at present, which can be taken in the balance sheet. Otherwise, you can write balance sheet, loose tools, ₹25,000. That is the given value in the trial balance, of which 1,000 as depreciation had been charged in the P&L account, it can be subtracted. That means less depreciation 1,000, the resultant figure 24,000 can be written in the amount column. You are having the freedom to choose either of these. Here, the amount of depreciation is not given in the adjustment, but the revalued price is given. In that case, we have to take the difference between the amount which is given in the trial balance and the revalued price which is given in the adjustment. If the revalued price is less, that means the difference denotes depreciation, which can be debited in the P&L account, and the revised value can be shown on the asset side of the balance sheet. The first case is revalued price of assets is given. And the second case, the amount of depreciation may not be given, but the rate of depreciation will be given. Let us illustrate. There is a trial balance, that is trial balance on 31/3/2020, plant and machinery ₹1 lakh. And in the adjustment, it is given that you have to provide depreciation at 10% on plant and machinery. Here, the value of the plant and machinery is ₹1 lakh. And it is given that you have to provide depreciation at the rate of 10%, which means 10% per annum on plant and machinery. What is the value of plant and machinery? 1 lakh. On 1 lakh, that you have to compute 10% that represents a depreciation. That means depreciation is equal to 1 lakh into 10 by 100 is equal to 10,000. Here the amount of depreciation is not given, but we calculated the depreciation at 10% on its value. Then make necessary entries. That means this rupees 10,000 depreciation can be debited in the P&L account to depreciation on plant and machinery rupees 10,000. Then in the balance sheet, this being an adjustment item, it will appear at two places, one on the debit side of the P&L account, another as a deduction from the concerned asset. That means plant and machinery rupees 1 lakh less depreciation 10,000, remaining 90,000 in the amount column. Here the amount of depreciation is not given, rate of depreciation is given. Hence number 2, rate of depreciation is given. These are the different situations that you may meet while solving the problems. First one, revalued price of asset will be given. Second one, rate of depreciation is given. Third one, rate of depreciation and date of purchase will be given. There is a time balance. It is also on 31/3/2020 trial balance. Two assets are given here, that is plant and machinery rupees 1 lakh, then furniture and fixtures, then one date is specified, that is 1/1/2020 rupees 50,000. Then you are required to provide depreciation at the 10% on plant and machinery and furniture and fixtures. Here two items are given in the trial balance as assets. They are plant and machinery and furniture and fixtures. In case of plant and machinery, no date is mentioned. That means the mere assumption is that it was there on the commencement of the year itself. That means we make use of that plant and machinery for 1 year. So we have to provide depreciation at the rate of 10% on plant and machinery for 1 year. The calculation is plant and machinery depreciation. Calculation is 1 lakh into 10 by 100. Then means rupees 10,000. But in case of the second item, that is furniture and fixtures, one date is given, that is 1/1/2020. That means we purchased that asset only on 1/1/2020. Thus, for the current accounting period, we made use of that particular asset only for 3 months, from 1st January 2020 to 31/3/2020, comprising 3 months. So we need to provide depreciation only for 3 months. What is the calculation? Depreciation on F&F furniture and fixtures, that is 50,000 into 10/100 into 3/12. That means 1,250. In the profit and loss account, you can write 2 depreciation. 1 plant and machinery. On plant and machinery, we got a figure of rupees 10,000. On furniture and fixtures, we got a figure of 1,250. That is F and F. Total depreciation is 11,250, which can be debited in the P&L. Thereafter, we have to write the balance sheet. Balance sheet. The first item is plant and machinery. The given value is rupees 1 lakh. Then out of which we have to subtract depreciation of plant and machinery, that is rupees 10,000. The resultant figure is 90,000 in the amount column. Then add another asset, that is furniture and fixtures. Its value is rupees 50,000 less provided depreciation 1250, that is 48,750. Here also, the depreciation which is given in the adjustment is taken at two places, that is P&L account and balance sheet. That is all. Then the fourth one, special care and attention is required. That is with respect to the erection charges of assets. Erection charges of assets. Fourth one, erection charges of assets. Once we purchase the certain assets, it has to be brought to the business premises and it should be fixed there. For fixing or erecting the asset, mainly in case of land and machinery, a certain amount will be paid to the technicians, to the workers as remuneration. The accountant may enter that amount under the head wages. It may be included under the head wages. But that is a wrong entry. If any amount is paid for the erection of a particular asset in an organization, that erection charges should be treated as capital charge. Capital charge will never be included in the trading and profit and loss account. It should be added to the cost of the asset. Let us see one example. There is a trial balance. Two items given are wages rupees 25,000. That is trial balance on 31/3/2020. Wages rupees 25,000. Plant and machinery rupees 1,24,000. It's a trial balance. Then in the adjustment, it is mentioned that wages includes rupees 1000 paid for erecting the machinery in the business unit. That is one. Number two, it is also mentioned that you have to provide depreciation at 10% on plant and machinery. See, two items are given in the trial balance. They are wages and plant and machinery. Wages is an item to be taken on the debit side of the trading account. And plant and machinery is an asset to be taken on the asset side of the balance sheet. Here it is given that wages includes rupees 1000 paid for erecting the machinery in the business unit. If any amount is paid for erecting an asset, it should not be included in the wages, because wages is a revenue item. The erection charge is not a revenue item but a capital item. Therefore, it should get corrected. That means from the wages, you have to eliminate or exclude 1000, because this 1000 is a capital charge, cannot be included under the head wages. That means while writing this trading account, you can write here to wages rupees 25,000 less erection charges. Erection charges rupees 1000 remaining 24,000 alone can be taken in the trading account. Then what about the balance sheet? The value of plant and machinery is 1,24,000. That is the cost. In addition to that, the erection charges is incurred, which is a capital item. It should also be added to the cost, and the resultant amount must be shown in the balance sheet. That means in the balance sheet, with this much of information, we can write, that is plant and machinery rupees 1,24,000 and erection charges 1000, then in the amount column 1,25,000. It can be written when, if there is no depreciation. If there is no depreciation, the erection charges should be deducted from the wages in the trading account and it should be added to the concerned asset in the balance sheet. Now, here there is depreciation also. That is at 10%. So, you have to calculate the depreciation. On which figure that you have to calculate? Not the figure which is given in the trial balance, but the figure you arrived at by adding these erection charges also. That means on rupees 1,25,000 that you have to calculate the depreciation. That means 1,25,000 into 10/100. That is 12,500. Have you got this 1,25,000? The given figure in the trial balance plus erection charges incurred. That is the total. That is 1,25,000 into 10/100. Thereby you will get 12,500 as depreciation. Then how it will be recorded? How it will be recorded in the trading and profit and loss account or the profit and loss account and balance sheet? P&L account, to depreciation on plant and machinery, rupees 12,500. Then again in the balance sheet, plant and machinery, that is 1,24,000 and erection charges 1,000. Thereby it comes 1,25,000, out of which we have to deduct the provided depreciation. Less depreciation, that is 12,500, the remaining is 1,12,500 in the amount column of the balance sheet. These are the various aspects connected with the depreciation. First of the items that we can see later in the coming sessions. Thank you.